så, mine damer og herrer, gik startskuddet til Copenhagen Half Marathon 2017. Løberne stævner ud med 21,74 km i timen, i hvert fald de allerforreste. Og så følger 22.000 glade løbere, som skal ud og sætte personlige rekorder og have fantastiske oplevelser i København. Alle jer, der står og kigger på, nyd det. Giv dem masser af hæb, masser af jubel. Det giver ekstra energi. Og når I kommer løbende her i startgaden, så får I lige lidt ild med på vejen, når løberne kommer med deres balloner. De er jo på arbejde, fartholderne, for at sørge for, at I får en god oplevelse. Og det vil sige, at jer, der løber ud lige om ganske kort tid, I bliver sendt varmt afsted. Ha' en rigtig, rigtig dejlig tur derude.
Vi skal lige være opmærksomme på til alle jer, der er på vej op mod startlinjen her, at når fartholderne de passerer startstregen, ja, så skyder vi altså ildkanoner af, og det giver altså en ordentlig drøn og en varmebølge her, så er I advaret.
Og vi har lige fået fartholdergruppen, som løber på 1.35 forbi, og lige om lidt følger næste. Og samtidig rammer de første løbere 1 km mærket. De er altså allerede godt i gang, men de skal også være i mål på omkring 58-59 minutter. Og til jer, der følger med på stream, og til jer, der kan se storskærmen, så kan I hver side af billedet se førerfelterne. I venstre side er det herrerne, som har løbet 1,7 km lige nu. I højre side er det kvinderne, som er et lille stykke efter. Vi har set, at herrernes herre, her kommer 1,45-ballon. Rigtig god tur til alle jer, der løber her. Vi har set, at herren, som fører de hurtigste herrer an, har været en lille smule foran måske. Har han lagt lidt hårdt ud, men nu er han nede i gruppen igen. 2,46 per kilometer, det er jo det, de skal holde. Vi har lige fået TV-verden Thomas Skov ude på ruten. Han kom løbende for et par minutter siden. Der er jo også en række kendte mennesker, der deltager her i dag og får en stor oplevelse sammen med alle jer andre, som skal ud og nyde Københavns og Frederiksbergs gader. Glæd jer til det hele. Der er masser af mennesker ude på ruten, som sådan set kun står derude for at heppe på jer.
Ja, du kan altså, når du løber på ruten, så kan du altså være heldig at støde ind i nogen, du måske har set i fjernsyn eller andre steder. Lad mig nævne Huber, som løber i dag. Camilla Andersen, håndboldspilleren. Du kan også møde Julie Bertelsen, sanger, nuværende radiovært. Du kan også møde vores landsholdstræner Claus Bruun Jørgensen. Du kan møde mange andre på turen her. Og så kan du til gengæld, så tager det jo kun lige om en time, inden de første løbere vender tilbage. Så med andre ord, så er der altså kun ganske få minutter nærmest fra den sidste løber er blevet sendt ud på ruten, til de hurtigste første løbere vender tilbage. Vi forsøger at skabe en fest her på målstregen. Vi glæder os til at se jer alle sammen igen om 21 km.
Og til alle jer, der er på vej ud på ruten, I har jo noteret jer, at vi har sørget for rigtig godt vejr i dag. Det er jo lidt overraskende med de vejrudsigter, vi har set tidligere på ugen. Det betyder, at det er en rigtig, rigtig god idé at være opmærksom på væskedepoterne. Der er masser af væske til jer derude. Sørg nu for at få drukket godt. En velhydreret krop, som det hedder, løber meget bedre end en, der ikke er. Så drik rigtig gerne ved alle væskedepoter. På den måde er I sikre på, at I har energi og væske nok til hele turen.
Så som sædvanlig tommelfingerreglen, Morten, drik før du bliver tørst, er det ikke sådan der?
Hvis man først begynder at drikke, når man kan mærke, at tørsten melder sig, så er det som hovedregel for sent. Så drik i rigtig, rigtig god tid, så er der mulighed for ikke at gå sukkerkold. Det er vist den positive måde at sige det på.
Så publikum her på Østre Allé, lad os sende løberne godt på vej ud.
Ved VM i maraton i London. I dag går han efter sejren. Det er jo også de danske mesterskaber, det handler om. Og vi er nået dertil i løbet, hvor vi skal have en 5 km mellemtid. Og vi har netop fået den, mine damer og herrer. De passerer de 5 km i 13.48. Det er 3 sekunder efter det aftalte tempo. Det er ikke særlig meget i den her sammenhæng. Det er stadigvæk hurtigere end verdensrekordtempoet, men altså lige lidt under det, som de havde aftalt.
Well, the news is at the head of the elite field that through 5 kilometers they are running 3 seconds inside world record schedule. We're still seeing thousands of runners off on their journey at the start line, and the cameras are riding with Abdi Ulad of Denmark, who's found himself a little bit isolated, but it's a leading group of around about 10 or 11 athletes plus pacemakers who've got away at the head of the men's field.
Og i billedet lige nu har vi de to, der kæmper om anden og tredje pladsen i det danske mesterskab. Det er Jesper Fagerskov fra Herning og Jesper Trebjerg Sørensen fra den arrangerende klub Sparta. Han er lige blevet europamester for Masters, så han er i god form. Jesper Favreskov har repræsenteret Danmark mange gange ved store mesterskaber. Her får de lidt opbakning, sådan lidt cykelstyle, som vi kender det fra Tour de France og andre begivenheder. Og Anders, masser af glade løbere på vej ud på ruten. Det er så godt at se. Her får vi fartholderballonen for jer, der skal løbe på 2 timer og 5 minutter. Nyd det derude. København er pyntet for jer, og alle glæder sig til at heppe på jer. Glæder jeg især til de mange super fede power zones.
Jesper Trebjerg Andersen of Denmark is the man in camera shot at the moment. He's got a lifetime best of 66.08. And I think he's operating inside that speed at the moment, but finds himself a long way back down the road behind the leading group.
Og vi har lige fået en mellemtid på de hurtigste kvinder. Og førerfeltet hos kvinderne passerer de første 5 kilometer på 15.44. Det er 1 sekund hurtigere, end de har aftalt. Og det betyder, at de ligger til en sluttid på lige omkring 67 minutter. Det I er vidne til, jer der sidder og følger med på storskærm og stream. Det er kort sagt løb i absolut verdensklasse. Og for herrenes vedkommende er vi altså inden for verdensrekordtempo. Og det er meget, meget sjældent, man ser så hurtigt løb her i Danmark.
News from the women's elite race to be on schedule for the course record of 68. They would have needed to go through 5 kilometers in 16.05. They are 21 seconds inside course record schedule for the women. So it's the two Jespers that we're looking at, Jesper Forshaug and Jesper Andersen of Denmark, second and third in the Danish Championships. Is it the championship within this?
Yes, and det er faktisk, nu skifter jeg lige til dansk, fuldstændig som planlagt. Abdi Olat ligger forrest, og de her to, Jesper og Jesper, kæmper om sølv og bronze. Det er to herrer, som er havnet lidt på mellemhånd.
So on the split screen, we can see the leading women and the leading men. 1.8 kilometers separating, or 0.8 of a kilometer separating them at the moment. Everybody's still in there that we would expect as the first pacemaker steps off to one side. His duties are done at 7 kilometers. And you can see that predicted time, 57.57, which would be just inside course record schedule if they can maintain it. And look at that amazing projected time for the women, 66 minutes. Absolutely fantastic speed being carved up by the women. They ask for quicker pacemaking and they're getting it.
Og det vi ser her på skærmen nu i vores split-screen-billede, det er de hurtigste mænd til venstre, de hurtigste kvinder til højre. Og som I kan se nede i hjørnet, så er der en estimeret sluttid, og den er beregnet på det tempo, de løber i lige nu. Og vi kan se, at for herrenes vedkommende er det 58 minutter og 8 sekunder, som det ser ud lige nu. Og det betyder jo altså, at de er 15 sekunder foran verdensrekordtempo. For kvindernes vedkommende, der er den estimerede sluttid lige omkring 66 minutter. Og vi ser Joanne Chelimo i det blå Adidas-tøj ligge lige bag haren. Hun var egentlig ikke sådan nævnt som en af de absolute favoritter. Men det er hende, som er helt op foran at presse haren. Og for mændenes vedkommende kan vi se, at haren rent faktisk er væk nu. Det er sidste års vinder James Wangari, der fører an. A little surprising that Wangari is in the lead already.
Well, we remember this from last year, don't we? He's a man that doesn't need pacemakers, even if they're there on offer. He went through 10 kilometers in an astonishing 27.21 last year, and I shouldn't think he's too far outside that at the moment. So the pacemakers struggling to keep up with Wangari, the defending champion, at the moment.
Og vi ser altså en stor klynge af både mænd og kvinder, som fører de respektive felter an. Og det betyder jo altså, at der er en lille smule hjælp. Vi skal lige huske, at herren, der løber til højre fra Wangardi her, det er Alex Oloy Tip-Tip Corio. Han er faktisk en del af Nikes Breaking 2-projekt, hvor han var hare for Eliud Kipchoge tidligere på året, da han løb 2:00:25. Og det vil sige, at Alex Corio, som han hedder her, altså også er en herre, der ved noget om at holde en stabil fart. Og Basuton, som blev nummer to ved verdensmesterskaberne i cross, han ligger lige bagved. Det er kenianerne i de orange trøjer. Og så har vi en række andre løbere, som følger med lige nu. De har ikke navne på brystet, men det er altså også ganske hurtige løbere. Ellers ville man ikke være her.
I'm a little bit surprised, I must admit, sorry, Anders, that they're taking on board water, because at the end of the day, they're only going to be running for 58 minutes. It's not especially hot. It's pretty nice, but it's not especially hot. But one took a drink, and they've all taken a drink. I think they've run out of pacemakers. The athlete that has elite number 11 on him is Joram Lumbasi Mkobo of Kenya. So everybody that we now see in shot is going the full distance, and it is quick.
Og vi har naturligvis det originale Team Tvilling, Sten og Peder i front. Det var dem, der begyndte det hele. Og prøv at se, hvor mange de har fået med. Det er en fornøjelse at se alle de glade løbere. Og der bliver skudt konfetti af og det hele. Det er jo en fest. Og samtidig kigger vi på førerfeltet, Anders. Det er Alex Corio, som har taget føringen. Vi nærmer os 9 km-mærket.
Og jeg bliver nødt til at spørge dig, Morten, for du er selv gammel eliteløber og løbeekspert. Hvorfor løber de så tæt? Det er jo lige før, de træder skoen af hinanden derude.
Det her, det handler om det, som rigtig mange har siddet og set i PostNord, Danmark rundt og Vueltaen og Tour de France. Det er simpelthen for at skærme hinanden mod vinden. Alex Corio, som vi ser nu, har lige afgivet føringen til en anden. Men han var med i det her Nike Breaking 2-projekt, og han var og der havde man simpelthen designet en måde at løbe på, sådan som man undgik at få vinden ind på sig. Og nu får vi faktisk lidt spredning her i førerfeltet. Something going on in the elite pack, Jeff.
Yes, in the men's race there's been a bit of a spurt. Corio seems to have been dictating the pace, and he's had to because the pacemakers have stepped aside. That time he's drifting outside 58 minutes. In the women's race, it's still holding at 66, which would be phenomenal racing. And as you can see, there are still a number of female and male pacemakers helping them as they approach 8 kilometers.
Ja, vi har også et par friske løbere fra Aarhus 1900 fra herresiden, som altså blander sig med de allerhurtigste kvinder. Og vi skal også lige huske, at vi lige nu er igennem Frederiksberg. Flagalléen, den smukke, smukke flagallé på Frederiksberg, det er jo et af kendetegnene, som løberne får lov til at opleve lige nu. En stor, stor nydelse for dem. 9,1 kilometer, og som I kan se på skærmen, mændene ligger til en sluttid på 58:17. Det er 6 sekunder hurtigere end verdensrekorden.
These fast times really set the scene for the runners that follow, because it's all about the reputation of Copenhagen worldwide as a course. As we've seen, 103 different nationalities are represented in the mass field, and if a proportion of those go back home with a personal best time, they'll come back for another attempt, maybe next year, and they'll bring with them other runners, friends, colleagues, teammates, who will also be looking for quick times. So it percolates all the way back down the field and enhances Copenhagen's reputation as a super fast course.
Og det er Jorum Okumbo fra Kenya, som har taget føringen hos herrerne. Nu er han lige rykket lidt ned i feltet igen. Han har en personlig rekord på 60:04, så det er sådan set lidt overraskende, at det er ham, der ligger og fører feltet an. Hos kvinderne ser vi meget mere samling, og her er det stadigvæk haren, som fører feltet an. Men det skrumper jo ind i førerfeltet. Der er en 8-10 løbere samlet nu. There are not that many in the leading pack right now. The speed is so high.
Yes, Okumbo is doing a bit of the work at the moment, the athlete with hip number 11. He's a 60:04 half marathon runner, and that appears to be the very minimum table stakes to be in that leading group at the moment. They're projecting for 58:14. It changes every few meters on the tracking. Meanwhile, in the women's, that has just drifted out a little bit. Maybe they've gone into a headwind section, although it is very light laps today.
Vi skal nok sige til, når løberne har ramt 10 km-mærket, og det har de forhåbentlig om meget, meget kort tid, og så skal I nok få en mellemtid. Det var jo aftalt, at de skulle løbe på 27:30, De er nok en lille smule efter det, men resultaterne burde tække ind om et øjeblik. Det her lignede det faktiske 10 km mærke, og vi får dem forbi her. 27.50, altså en mellemtid på 27.50. De er 20 sekunder efter det aftalte tempo, og begynder altså at være et lille stykke uden for rækkevidde, når det gælder verdensrekorden. Til gengæld er der rigtig mange samlet, så det kan være, at det kan hjælpe lidt. A little out of reach of the world record right now, Jeff.
Yeah, they needed to go through 10 kilometers in 27.30, and they went through 20 seconds outside that. We've got a great race in prospect, because on paper, all of these men are going the full distance now, so just approaching the halfway point. 21.1 kilometer race, and all looking pretty good. In the women's race, we're still tracking at 66.17. That just seems to be whittling down very slightly. There'll be a couple of pacemakers in there who will step out, leaving us with maybe six athletes in contention.
Og hos kvinderne ser vi, at det stadigvæk er Haren, der fører an. Det er Joanne Melli i det blå tøj, som ligger lige bagved, sammen med forhåndsfavoritten Brigitte Kosgei fra Kenya. Og det er nok mellem de to, vi skal finde den sejrende kvinde. Og vi kan se, at de løber så stærkt, så de hurtigste danske herrer har svært ved at følge med. Det er også et ganske højt tempo, de ligger i. De ligger til en sluttid på 66.17, og det er altså verdensklasse-tempo, også her på dansk grund for kvindernes vedkommende.
You have to laugh at the two men at the back of that women's group, because they're adding nothing. They're contributing nothing. They're just hitching a ride, getting on television, aren't they?
Don't be hard on the Danish men, Jeff. They're doing their absolutely best, and they're from Aarhus.
Aarhus. Fair play, but they're struggling.
Yeah, very hard. Og så ser vi faktisk hos herrerne igen, at nu er det Wangari og Orio, altså Olio Tip-Tip, som fører an, og det er jo Wangari, sidste års vinder, som kommer til at gøre rigtig meget arbejde. It seems, Jeff, that Wangari, he needs to do the job himself again.
He's a natural frontrunner, isn't he? That's always his inclination, to just edge ahead. We saw it in the opening couple of kilometers. And when he reached this point a year ago, he was in complete isolation. There's some smoke in the background. I don't know what's going on there.
That's the spectators having fun. Yeah.
Just ignited with excitement. But he was way out on his own, and we thought it was a really suicidal pace that he was setting. In the end, he almost held it together. It was only the wind that cost him that super fast time. Still a course record, but at one stage he was way inside world record speed.
Som Jeff lige fortæller her, Wangari var på egen hånd sidste år. Der rykkede han faktisk fra Harne allerede ved 4 km mærket, sådan lidt efter det, og løber altså alene i 17 km. I dag har han meget bedre hjælp fra den her gruppe af løbere, og Correo ser ud til at være den, der skal hjælpe ham allermest. Og så den Dark Horse Barsutton, han ligger og hygger sig lidt nede i feltet, og det kan jo altså godt blive farligt for de andre, når vi nærmer os slutningen. And Jeff, we are also approaching the point where the wind is coming in on the route at 12.5 kilometers. What does it mean that they're together at this point?
Well, they're getting some shelter. Your two men from Aarhus are going over to the drink stations. But as long as they stay together, in terms of any headwind that they might encounter, in terms of being able to work off each other's pace, then it helps to have as big a group as you can, as far into the race as you can. And I think that's particularly important for those that are making their debuts. To be isolated in no woman's land, no man's land, would be a very difficult thing at this point in the course. But they're working together, and those that are cross-country specialists, track specialists, will still be feeling relatively comfortable at this point.
And I think that the guy from Aarhus, he heard you. Now he's in front.
He's helping out. He's suddenly doing a shift, isn't he?
He's watching the stream while he's running. It must be so. Vinderne er samlet, og de passerer 10 km mærket her. Vi skal lige have den aktuelle mellemtid. Det ser faktisk også ud til, at kvinderne har tabt en lille smule af den høje fart, de havde. Vi får en mellemtid, der hedder 31.43. 31.43 for the women. That's 13 seconds outside the deal they made yesterday.
But it's still massively inside the course record. For a course record schedule at 68 minutes, 32.10 would have been the ideal time for 10 kilometers. So as they approach halfway, they are way, way inside the fastest time ever seen in Denmark.
Og vi kan faktisk fortælle fra det tekniske møde, der var i går, at de allerhurtigste kvinder egentlig havde planlagt at løbe efter en tid på 68 minutter. Men især Joanne Malley, som vi ser i det blå tøj, og Brigitte Kosgei i den orange trøje, de var interesserede i at løbe hurtigere. De ville gerne løbe på 67 minutter, så Haren foran dem, han lavede en aftale med dem i går og blev altså kastet ind i løbet som lidt sent. I'm just talking about the women yesterday. They wanted to increase the speed from the pace setter, going for 67 instead of 68.
Well, and that looks justified at the moment. But look at the difference in formation. The women's pack, you could almost throw a blanket over them. They're very, very tight formation, and the men are just drifting. And I'm amazed at the number of them that are going for drink stations in a fairly temperate, less than 1 hour run. That can only be... I don't know, just routine that they're accustomed to in half marathons, but it could cost them their rhythm and it could cost them their place.
Last year we talked about Wangari looking at his watch a lot of the time. Maybe the drinking situation is something he needs to do to feel confident.
Yeah, every runner has their routines. He did look at his watch an awful lot without actually stopping to register anything. It was almost like a nervous reaction. But the men have now regained formation. I don't know if anybody actually took a drink there. I don't know if they were looking for their specially prepared drinks, or they weren't very successful at grabbing at the previous station, so maybe thought better of it. But also, it's quite overcast now as well, isn't it?
Yeah. Og det er Okumbo fra Kenya, som tager føring, og lige mens jeg siger det, er det Kurio, som går frem. And now this is actually the splitting point of this route, Jeff. We're approaching Kalvebrud Brygge. We're approaching the headwind. They're going to take a turn left in just a few seconds, and then we'll see what it'll end with.
Yeah, I've been looking at the weather forecast for this race all week, and at no point was anything stronger than 7 kilometers per hour forecast, and that's mild. You know, they'll be used to that in training. You would count that as just a normal day, and a good day in Copenhagen with its coastal location. So they should take full advantage. One or two of them tucking in, you can see. So it's going to be a very exciting race to find out who our champions are this year. And in the case of the women, it is almost certainly going to be the fastest time ever seen in Denmark.
You can actually see the women looking at each other. Millie and Kosgei, they're just doing these side looks at each other. Who's strong, who's not, what does he have? And then the men, they are in the headwind now.
Well, Joan Chilimo Melli is very much the apprentice. She hasn't actually lost at international level, but I think she's still very much in her first year of racing. So this would be the biggest win of her career if she could pull it off. But she's never raced a half marathon. She's only gone as far as 10K. So she'll be looking to the more senior established athletes as to whether it's too quick, too slow, or just right. And there's your answer on the breeze. Absolutely perfect. Barely fluttering.
Og vi kan også lige tage mellemtiderne for de bedste danske herrer. Det er sådan, at Abdi Ouellat er alene i front ved 10 km mærket. Han repræsenterer jo Hvidovre Atletik og Motion. Han løber 30-25 ved 10 km mærket, og han er et par 30 sekunder foran de to Jesper Fagersgaard og Jesper Andersen. De kommer forbi i 30-56, og så er der et stort hul ned til Ulrik Heitmann og Jakob Markussen fra Aarhus 1900, som jo altså løber sammen med de hurtigste kvinder og bliver drillet en lille smule af Jeff. That's the fast guys from Aarhus I was talking about. They're number 4 and 5 in the national championships.
So they're going okay. They're proper runners, even though they're hitching a ride. Well, and in the women's race, you can see that's still a huge lead pack, whereas we've had a significant move now put in by the Bahrainian athlete in the men's race. And that has really opened things up a little bit. Abraham Sherobin, fastest man in the field, with a best of 58.48. And he's just testing them out with a few little surges. And you can see the damage is being done behind him, because that group, there was a nice cozy 10, now looks like it's becoming a 4 or a 5.
And who's gone, Jeff? James Wangari.
Wangari is at the back of that group in the orange singlet. So the defending champion can see up ahead that his title may be slipping away.
Yeah. Så det er Kurio og det er Basuton af forhåndsfavoritterne, som er med nu. Cheroben, som altså har løbet 58-48, sætter så højt tempo, at sidste års mester James Wangari er blevet sat i førergruppen, som nu begynder at ligne en meget lille gruppe, kun bestående af 5 løbere, som ser ud til at være dem, der skal afgøre det imellem sig. Også lidt overraskende, Okumbo from Kenya, he'd done 60-04 before. So this is a very fast race by him in the blue.
Yeah, there's one or two opportunities for surprise winners here, but it certainly doesn't look like it's going to be Wangari. And to add insult to injury, it looks as though his course record may go down, but to who? At this point, it could be any one of these leading four or five, but there has been a big move over that last kilometer. The three behind desperately trying to get their way back into contention, but I think it is just a distance too far for Wangari. He spoke at the press conference about injuries, only been back in training since July, and 14 kilometers, two-thirds done, one-third to go. That's when you get found out, isn't it?
Yeah. And actually, you see Okombo, he's pressing it really hard right now. And you have Basaton there in the back, just behind Carrillo. Basaton, number two at the World Cross Championships. He's a dark horse here, because I think he's very strong. He's a debutant on the half marathon, but he's going to do very well in his debut.
Okombo actually is barely old enough to run a half marathon. He was born in 1997. You have to be 18 to run at international level. So he's worked his way up to this distance very quick. It looks like he's clicking his fingers, doesn't it, with his right arm and yeah. Blowing his nose as well at the same time. But a very relaxed, languid running action, and it's working really well for him at the moment. We're down to five. There's the defending champion. Oh, no, hey. There's the Danish number one.
Yeah, Ulad. Ulad on his own. He's 30 seconds before the other Danes, men han helt alene ved Kalvebod Brygge, Abdi Ulad. Han har prøvet det masser af gange før, det har han det fint med. Her ser vi, hvordan det ser ud hos de danske mænd. Jeg synes også lige, vi skal nævne mellemtiderne for de danske kvinder ved 10 km-mærket. For her fører Simone Glad fra Sparta, men kun et sekund foran Anna Holm, OL-løber, også fra Sparta. Hun havde egentlig ikke planlagt at løbe så hurtigt. Simone Glad planlagde også at løbe ud i 3.30 per kilometer. Det er jo 35 på 10 kilometeren, men hun er et pænt stykke foran det. På tredjepladsen, også som forventet, Louise Langelund Batting fra Aarhus 1900. Og hun er kun 20 sekunder bag ved de to nævnte, så det kan godt være, at det bliver spændende. More happening in the elite field.
Well, this is the men's race. A couple of them are just barely getting back in touch. It's Kenya right the way across that leading group. It's going to be a Kenyan winner here. They're still projecting, there we are, 58.23. So a course record in prospect for the men, and a massive course record and one of the fastest times in the world this year for the elite women, if they can hold it together. Their pacemaker, their male pacemaker, doing a great job, but still four, five women now in contention, along with your man. I think the second man from your hometown has drifted off.
Please don't call Aarhus my hometown. That's a joke here in Denmark, Jeff.
Okay. Not your hometown, Aarhus.
Vi har lige fået de hurtigste mænd ned igennem området ved Børsen. Vi venter på en 15 km mellemtid. Det varer ikke så længe, før vi får den. Og læg lige mærke til, at der er løbet i 41 minutter og 25 sekunder. Det er et voldsomt højt tempo, der bliver løbet i Københavns gader. Vi skal naturligvis have den fuldstændig korrekte mellemtid ved 15 km mærket, som de nærmer sig her. That's the 15 km mark, Jeff. Approaching here.
So the splits we were looking for the men to be on course record schedule would be around about 41:15. So a little bit outside. Well, no, that's a 58-second schedule, a 58-minute schedule, yeah. Actually. So they're inside course record, operating at around 58 and a half.
De er meget, meget tæt på verdensrekordtempo, men lidt udenfor. Til gengæld så er de pænt indenfor, når det gælder ruterekorden, som jo altså er 59.07, den kommer James Wangari nok til at vinke farvel til. Han har jo mistet sin tilladelse til at være i førergruppen. Han er simpelthen gået kold. Så lige nu er det Okombo, det er Chiroben, det er Carrillo, og det er Kangogo og Basaton.
And Kangogo is really hanging on by his fingertips at the moment, isn't he? He's been fifth place and two or three strides behind. And you can see with every single injection of pace that comes in, he's finding it harder and harder and harder. So this is the Bahrainian athlete as we go through into the 16th kilometer, still operating at 58.25. Meanwhile, with the women, it is getting quicker. 66.08 now, the projected time. The man from Aarhus, still in the middle there, host to the World Cross Country Championships in 2018.
Yeah.
We're looking forward to that. Denmark put on a great event. First time ever hosting the World Cross Country Championships.
Og nu kan vi se oppe i førergruppen, at det begynder at snærpe til. Det er Tiroben, som repræsenterer Bahrain, som sætter et højt, højt tempo. Og det er altså også rigtig hårdt for Barsuton, og Kangogo har også hængt lidt. Så det ser ud til, at den, der har den hurtigste tid til at starte med på 58-48, Tiroben fra Bahrain, det er ham, der sætter tempoet lige nu. Tiroben, he's really working hard now. He's got Barsuton too.
Well, he's just sensed that this may be the opportunity to put in a bit of a surge and see if he can whittle it down to three runners. And that tactic seems to be working at the moment. He's a track specialist, the Bahrainian. He's run the last two Olympic, the Olympic 10,000 meters and the World Championship 10,000 meters in London this summer. He was 12th in London and he was 10th in Rio. So he's got some wheels there that he can use over the closing kilometers.
And he's pushing now.
Long run for home.
He's pushing now. Han prøver virkelig til Tiroben at komme af med de to kenyanske forfølgere. Det er jo Okumbo og Corio, som forsøger at hænge på. Men hvis I kigger ned i venstre hjørne, så står der estimeret sluttid 58-26. Det er så tæt på verdensrekorden, som det næsten kan være. Som Jeff lige sagde, Tiroben er en rutineret herre. Han har rigtig mange kvaliteter som løber, og lige nu viser han rigtig mange af dem.
So we're down to three in the men's, and spectacularly, we are down to three women in the elite race, and they are still operating very, very close to 66-minute pace. It is still the outsider.
Joan Melly.
Yeah.
Bridget Koskaj.
Is the one that we were expecting to cause fireworks here.
And I think it's Eunice Chumba that's there on the right side. It is.
So the seeding's pretty good here because we've got three of the top four seeds away and clear now in the women's race with two men for company and a super fast time prospect.
Og Tiroben, han arbejder virkelig, virkelig hårdt i førerfeltet her. Han vil rigtig gerne af med Corio og Okumbo. Vi er tilbage på Frederiksberg, sådan som jeg lige kan se vejnettet i København. This is really fast, Jeff. He's pushing so hard right now.
Well, the men are now inside the last 5 kilometers of the race. And that's a distance they would do every single time they go out for a training run. 5 kilometers, 3 miles, it's nothing, except if you're feeling really on the edge of your limits. And to me, although he's looked like it for a lot of the race, the guy wearing 11, Joram Lumbasi Onkobo in the blue there on the right, elite number 11, looks uncomfortable, but he has looked, he's got a very unique style, and he's looked in difficulty at different stages, but he's still there.
And he's only 20 years of age. It's a very young runner. So for him, this distance is very long. He's looking back now, and he's looking a bit stressed, but he's hanging on tighter than Carrillo, actually.
Yep, this is a crucial stage in the race. Born 1997. I've got shirts older than that.
Og hvis vi kigger over hos kvinderne, something happening in the women's field. Maybe it's the drink station doing this, but there is a little mix here.
Yeah, the pacemaker is doing a fantastic job. You sense that he may be capable of going the whole distance with him. But I haven't seen any of the women take drinks on board. The men have almost taken the opportunity and it's shaped the race. I haven't seen any women take drinks, at least not in those leading three. So correction there, two of them grabbed a drink at the last drink station. They've opened up a massive gap on a group that was pretty tight just 2 kilometers ago. And as we look at Tiroben, is that surging tactic starting to work?
Og her kommer kvinderne så ned mod 15 kilometer mærket. Det er i meget, meget høj fart. Det her bliver med sikkerhed den hurtigste tid på dansk grund. En af de allerhurtigste tider i verden nogensinde. Og det er tre kvinder, som kæmper om sejren og om al den ære, der følger med. Og Jakob Markussen fra Aarhus 1900 følger med, det bedste han har lært. Vi får mellemtiderne ind om ganske kort tid, håber vi. Og her kommer de. 47-24, 47-24 for the leading pack. It's Koskaj, Chumba and Melly, as we spoke about.
And 48-15 would have been the schedule to break the course record. So as they have been from the first kilometer, they are way, way inside the Danish all-comers record, the course record, and one of the fastest times in the world this year.
Det er, mine damer og herrer, verdensklasse løb, I er vidner til, hvad enten I kigger med i Københavns gader via app, eller og står og kigger på herude på ruten. Jeg der står her på Østre Allé, gør jeg klar til at byde de her atleter velkommen. De har lige passeret Christiansborg, og her ser vi de førende herrer. De har altså 4 km, mindre end 4 km til mål. I deres tempo, så tager det en 10-11 minutter. Og det er Chiropen, Jeff, he's doing the hard work right now.
Yeah, you've got two very contrasting races. None of the women are having to do a single step in front because the pacemaker is doing such an exceptional job. But for Chiropen, he is absolutely throwing everything at this. We're into the last 4 kilometers now. He's put in a very quick last segment that has brought them down to 58:20 as a projected finishing time, and yet still he's got a challenge from two others for the title.
Og måske sker der lidt i kvindefeltet her. Der er en af løberne, der er ved at falde af. One of the women falling off. Would that be Eunice Chumpa falling a little bit behind?
I think it is.
Yeah, that's her. But the pacemaker, he's doing all the work. The women are just hanging on to him.
So that's the leading two in the Danish championship.
Yeah.
It's Simona Glad and Anna Holm. Pretty disappointed with their allocation of bodyguards from Bodyguards Are Us, but they've certainly turned up in force around the leading two Danish women.
Og hvis vi lige giver jer mellemtiderne for de hurtigste mænd, så ser det sådan ud, at Abdi Olat stadigvæk er alene i front, når det gælder det danske mesterskab. 15 km passeret i 45:57, cirka 40 sekunder efter Jesper og Jesper, Fagerskov og Andersen, 46:39. Og så altså et stykke efter dem, Jakob Markussen fra Aarhus 1900. Han løber sammen med kvinderne og passerer i 47:25.
So less than 4 kilometers now to run for the elite men. It is still Joram Lumbasi and Kobo in the dark blue vest. It is the fastest man in the field, Abraham Chiropen of Bahrain. And they are having no joy in shaking off Corio, the track specialist, or rather the breaking two specialist. Pace made that Nike attempt on a sub 2 hour marathon back at Monza in the spring. It's a very skippy sort of action, isn't it, that Chiropen's got. You would think with his 10,000 meter pedigree that he would be the man for a sprint finish.
Yeah.
Because he certainly had to demonstrate that to qualify for teams and to make finals. But you never know. Behind him, somebody looking for the biggest win of their lives, the biggest race of their lives, gets inspired in the home straight. It is a long home straight here in Copenhagen. They see the finish long before they should be sprinting. But that automatically draws you towards it.
Yeah.
And it will be a question of timing in these closing stages.
And you can see Okombo, maybe it's because he's young and unexperienced, but now his head is flipping, you can see his teeth. He looks a little more tired than the others. Maybe you would go for Carrillo because he has the experience to do this, and he's just been behind looking at the back of the two others. He's been doing nothing actually, and he's used to doing a lot.
Well, Chiropen is the man you would expect to sit in and maybe use his kick, but he's led for about the last 20 minutes of the race, and it's done nothing to get rid of these two. But as you say, 11 on Kobo in the blue. Is he starting to struggle? Is this his point of no return? Because if he can get to within a kilometer of the finish, he'll be able to hang on. But this is the point where the race could be blown wide apart. Meanwhile, in the women's, still the one pacemaker, still the three women in there. They haven't had to lead for any step of the race, so it's been a completely different tactical and mindset race for them. And the time is still coming down. We still have the prospect of a sub 66 because it might take that to actually win this race.
And Chumba, she's hanging. She's getting back to the pack. We see Kenyans do that a lot, but it's a strange time of the race to do that. She must be more tired than the others. It should be between Melly and Koskai.
You would think, but we wrote her off about 5 minutes ago and she's still there, Chumba. That's a tantalizing gap, but she does look a little bit more ragged, doesn't she, than the two up ahead. In fact, it's Chumba on the left? Chumba on the left, Chalima on the right. So the runner
is Koskai hanging.
It's Koskai that's struggling.
Yeah. So it's actually the favorite hanging right now. As we see in the men's race, Wangari, he's far away. Now Okombo, he's making a move. The young runner at the age of 20 years, he's challenging them. This is crazy.
Is this the last shake of the dice, or has he come through his bad patch? Have the others hit a bad patch? They are still projecting way inside the course record. We're on 53 and a half minutes. We expect them across the line less than 5 minutes from now. And the women still closing in on 66 minutes. That would be amazing, but it looks like it's down to two plus the male pacemaker.
Måske er det kenyanerne, der samarbejder lidt her. Vi så Okumbo lige være op og ryste Chiropen lidt. Maybe the Kenyans are working together against the guy from Bahrain because they could shake him a little maybe. In Korea, he has done nothing as of yet.
Well, it's as you were, the same three men in the same order. So that was perhaps a last-ditch attempt. The pacemaker in the women's race has really, I mean, I don't know if he's a beer drinker, but they should buy him beers for the rest of this month at least, shouldn't they? Because yeah. He has towed them to an astonishing time, and he's done it without them needing to do a single step of leading. So it's great pacemaking.
Men mine damer og herrer, der er altså cirka 1,5 kilometer til mål, en 1500 meter. Det er alt, der skal til for de hurtigste herrer. Det ser ud til en rigtig, rigtig hurtig sluttid. Vi får en mellemtid ved 20 km mærket lige om lidt, og så drejer de ind mod Trianglen og ned ad Øster Allé. Og så er det altså, at de her fantastiske løbere skal mærke jeres varme velkomst. Det her bliver en ruterekord. Det bliver den hurtigste tid på dansk grund nogensinde. Det er vi helt sikre på. Hvor tæt de kan komme på verdensrekorden, det ved vi ikke helt endnu. Det får vi en indikation af lige om lidt. I'm just talking about, Jeff, 1 kilometer to go approximately. We are closing in. Close to the world record, under the race record. This is fantastic.
It is fantastic, and look at their faces, look at the pain. I don't think one or two of them have got any surges left in them, and yet Chiroba is trying to kick again. The crowds are getting thicker. They've got just one last big turn before they see the finish. We'll be seeing the outrider vehicles accelerate away, and it is everyone for himself in this last kilometer. At the
27th,
who's going to be the new course record holder? Who's going to be the new champion?
And they're approaching the 20-kilometer mark here in a time under 56 minutes. And they are closing in on Öster Allé. They're going to be here pretty soon. This is absolutely fantastic racing. We have 55:51 as the split time. It's going to well inside the 59 minutes. How close to the world record can this be?
Well, they've shown they're capable on their day, but nobody is a winner yet. Chiroben has tried so hard. They're either side of the median now. That could be a crucial decision to stay left. But we are in for a grandstand finish. Let's get ready to start pumping up the volume. We're going to have a new course record, but we've no idea who is going to set it, because it is still just 1 second separating Chiroben, the long-term leader, from Okumbo and from the other
Carrillo.
Carrillo.
And Carrillo, he's actually falling a little off now. We don't know if that's a show. They're going in on Öster Allé. They're very close to the finishing line. And it's going to be Chiroben and Okumbo, the young runner. They're in here for your applause. This is going to be a fantastic time. Look at the speed. And we know, Jeff, at this point, it's all inside the head. It's between the ears.
It's a duel. We have the fastest man in the field against the rank outsider, Chiroben of Bahrain, against the Okumbo of Kenya.
And now he's going. This is the hard kick from Chiroben. He's going to take it, but Okumbo, he won't give up. He just won't give up. The young runner from Kenya, only 20 years old. Og de er herinde på opløbet nu, mine damer og herrer. Det her, det fortjener alt den larm, Öster Allé kan give.
Kom så, Öster Allé, op med larmerne!
So the course record,
59.07.
59.07. They've got a minute and 20 seconds to finish.
Og I kan se dem dernede, mine damer og herrer. De løber, jeg vil tro, et sted mellem 3 og 24 km i timen lige nu. Det er 4 km i timen hurtigere, end løbebånd kan klare, når man skruer det helt op. De skal mærke al jeres energi nu. Der mangler så lidt. Chiroben is in the lead.
So Chiroben has tried to get away. It hasn't worked until the last kilometer. Keep your eye on the clock. He's got 45 seconds to break the course record.
Kom så, mine damer og herrer. Lav noget.
It is Abraham Chiroben of Bahrain, going in for the victory. Se på hastigheden. Det er vinderen af Copenhagen Half Marathon 2017.
Abraham Cheroban is the Copenhagen Half Marathon champion, and it's the fastest time ever seen in Denmark.
Og vi får tre mænd under 59 minutter. Okumbo fra Kenya, 20 år gammel. Alex Oloi, Tip Corio, he's in here too.
Okumbo second, and Corio in third.
Det her, mine damer og herrer, det er det hurtigste, det vildeste, det bedste løb, vi har set på dansk jord nogensinde. Det tør jeg godt stå og sige. Cheroban kommer til med en tid på 58.48 som personlig rekord, og han beviser, at denne her rute er en af de allerhurtigste, hvis ikke den hurtigste i verden. Nummer 4 og 5 kommer ind her. Giv dem en stor hånd. Det er løber, der løber langt under en time. Kan go og Marathon fra Kenya. En af favoritterne, som kommer i mål her. Han debuterer på halvmaraton, mine damer og herrer. 59.30.
Højester lige fortsat tager rigtig godt imod verdenseliten, de hurtigste løbere i verden, på vej over målstregen.
Og de her to kommer også under den magiske time. Det er fantastisk. Kovic her, 59-52, sådan i runde tal. Og der er stadigvæk masser af fart på de hurtige løbere. Det her, det er et løb i verdensklasse. Det her, det kommer til at tiltrække endnu flere fantastiske løbere til næste år. København med gold label, som fortjent. Now we have Jägeren i mål her.
We have the winner, Abraham Cheroban, just beyond the finish line. You tried so hard to get away. Were you getting anxious that you might not win?
The training is very good.
Happy with the time? It was a course record. It was 58.20. Pleased with that?
That is good.
What do you think you can run for a half marathon?
This one is 40 time.
Will you come back next year and defend your title?
And come back.
Deal. We'll see you next year.
Giv ham en stor hånd, mine damer og herrer. Løbets vinder, Abraham Cheroban fra Bahrain, leverer en fantastisk præstation på dansk grund. Og lige om lidt, så får vi Abdi Ulan i mål. Han kommer til at vinde det danske mesterskab. Han er på vej i ensom majestæt, samtidig med, at vi ser fantastiske løbepræstationer fra de afrikanske løbere. Her er det Tarus, der kommer i mål. Også en flot, flot sluttid. Selvom han er langt efter de allerhurtigste, så er det her jo altså tider, som er helt fantastiske. Til sammenligning, Danmarks rekorden, som har stået i så mange år, er på 61.55. Prøv at se, hvor mange løbere vi har fået under den. Det siger altså lidt om niveauet, mine damer og herrer.
En ganske speciel dag her i København, I har været vidne til og fortsat er vidne til. Vi mangler jo stadigvæk 22.000 løbere over målstregen.
Og her synes jeg, at vi skal give en rigtig, rigtig stor hånd til løberen, der nærmer sig målstregen her. Det er en løber, som har givet alt, hvad han har. Mine damer og herrer, det er sidste års vinder, James Wangari. Han gik med, han gjorde, hvad han kunne, og han løber 62.04, selvom han nærmest går ind over målstregen. Fantastisk præstation.
Så Wangari, the 2016 champion, across the line, just outside 62 minutes. Arnie Gabius of Germany, the first European finisher, and a great time for the German number one.
Arnie Gabius fra Tyskland har den tyske rekord på maraton 2:08:25, så vidt jeg husker, blander sig med de allerhurtigste afrikanere. Vi nærmer os Abdi Ulan på målstregen. Han har løbet helt alene hele vejen. Han bliver dansk mester i dag, og det kan ikke bare længe, før vi ser ham her på Øster Allé. Og vi skal selvfølgelig også have fulgt med i løbet hos de allerhurtigste kvinder. De kommer i mål om sådan cirka 3 minutter. Vi har ikke fulgt dem her de sidste mange minutter, men lad os se, om ikke vi kan få billeder ud fra ruten. De kommer i mål omkring 67 minutter, op de inde på den sidste kilometer. Og der var jo altså tre kvinder, som kæmpede om det. Chumba, Koskaj og Melli. Og det er billeder af dem, vi ser her. Paceren, han ligger og pacer dem frem. He's waving them ahead. It's Chumba, it's Melli. Estimated time, 105.57, sorry.
What an astonishing time. Look, he's urging the crowd on, the pacemaker. multitasking. We are going to see a huge new course record, but who's going to get it? Fantastic race now in prospect between these two in the women's event, and one of the fastest times in history.
He's pushing them so hard, the pacemaker. He wants the speed to go up. You cannot measure the predicted time. It's going to be a little slower than that because of the GPS system. You can see that they lag a little until they are triangle.
Well, and
yeah, Melly, som ser ud til at være stærkest. Melly looks the strongest right now.
Approaching the final turn. She's undefeated at international level. She's very new on the scene. But Joan Chelimo-Melly could be a new superstar in the making, but she hasn't got this race won yet. There's the final right-hand turn, and then the long, long home straight.
De mangler 1 kilometer. Det er Melly, det er Chumba. Og på opløbsstrækning, mine damer og herrer, vi vil rigtig gerne have en stor hånd til dagens hurtigste dansker fra Hvidovre Atletik og Motion, Abdi Hakim Ullerts. Han er lige kommet hjem fra VM i London, hvor han blev nummer 13 på maraton. Han har overskud i dag, og der er noget, han elsker. Det er publikum, der hæpper på ham. Giv en stor hånd, mine damer og herrer. Det er den danske mester, vi ser her. Abdi Ullerts, dansk mester på halvmaraton. Et pænt stykke fra sin personlige rekord. Han havde slet ikke regnet med at være i nærheden. Så det her er en flot, flot præstation.
Well, spare a thought for Eunice Chumba, because she was last year's runner-up. She does not want that to happen again, and she's determined it's not going to happen again. She's taken the lead in the home straight, on schedule for a course record, the pacemaker being directed off, and it is Eunice Chebici Chumba, the Copenhagen runner-up of 2016, who at the moment is heading for victory, and one of the fastest times in history.
Og nummer 2 i Danmarks mesterskabet, Jesper Fagerskov fra Herning, som her tager sølvmedaljen. Og så er det, som Jeff siger, Chumba, Eunice Chumba, som har sat det afgørende angreb ind. I kan næsten se, hvordan Joan Melly lidt længere tilbage går fuldstændig tør for kræfter. Det ser vi tit. Hun har holdt fast. And now on the finish line, Eunice Chumba.
So the women's course record was 68 minutes exactly. Not anymore. She's going to take almost 2 minutes off that. The Copenhagen Half Marathon champion for 2017 for Bahrain is Eunice Chumba.
Det her, mine damer og herrer, er en fantastisk præstation af de hurtigste kvinder. Eunice Chumba vinder, og her Joan Melly på slutstregen. Velkommen i mål til en flot, flot præstation.
And Joan Chelimo-Melly takes the silver medal.
Og Bridget Koskaj kommer i mål her på tredje pladsen. De er så tæt.
Bridget Koskaj of Kenya in third.
De er alle sammen over 1 minut og 20 sekunder hurtigere end den eksisterende ruterekord. De sætter personlige rekorder alle sammen. Jeg sagde det, da mændene kom i mål. Det her er en af verdens allerhurtigste ruter. Måske den hurtigste. Det får vi bevist i dag. Vi skal lige give en hånd til nummer 3 i det danske mesterskab fra den arrangerende klub Sparta. Jesper Trebien. Kom så, Jesper. Vi giver den det sidste. Publikum hjælper dig. En mand, der har givet alt bronze i de danske mesterskaber. Rigtig, rigtig flot præstation. Vi får stadigvæk kvinder i mål, pænt under den eksisterende ruterekord på 68 minutter. Den er blevet smadret i dag. Og vi får også de hurtige aarhusianske løbere i mål. Ulrik Heitmann slår Jakob Markussen i spurten her, tager fjerdepladsen i mændenes mesterskab. Nummer 4 og nummer 5 kommer fra Aarhus 1900. Og vi får stadigvæk masser af hurtige kvinder i mål. Torkild Stundstrup rammer målstregen. Mændene vælter ind i høj fart. Giv dem en stor hånd, mine damer og herrer.
So here I am, sitting on the curb with the new Copenhagen Half Marathon champion, Eunice Chumba. A very, very good time. Congratulations. Are you pleased?
Thank you.
You were second last year. You were pretty determined you weren't going to be second at the finish today, weren't you?
Yes, I was second, but this time I decided not to be even toy at the pacemaker. Decided after 15 guy, he decided not to go outside, but I say yes, let me take advantage so that I improve my PB.
This must be your favorite course, is it?
Yeah, this is my first time now.
Is it the biggest win of your career? Your biggest win on the roads?
Yeah, my biggest win. This is my first time to be a top athlete. 66 minutes, I have improved a lot.
We're very impressed. Congratulations. Will you come back next year?
Yeah, thank you. I will come next year. This is a good place, a faster course. This is nice. I will come next year.
And meanwhile, the beers are on you tonight, aren't they?
Thank you.
Well done.
En stor hånd til dagens vinder hos kvinderne, Eunice Tumba, som satte Jeff Whiteman på det, vi godt kan kalde hårdt arbejde. Her får vi Sarah Hall i mål. Hun kommer fra Amerika. Hun havde forsøgt at løbe under 70 minutter, og hun rammer altså også dagen i dag. Hun er gift med Ryan Hall, som nogen vil kende som den eneste hvide mand, der nogensinde har været under en time på halvmaraton. Nu har hans kone præsteret at løbe under 70 minutter. Og vi venter lige nu på de to hurtigste danske kvinder, Anna Holm og Simone Glad, som nærmer sig målstregen. Det er bare et stykke tid, før vi får op.